Let's talk Black Ops 6. You guys have probably seen the Microsoft Direct footage, saw the announcement, read through what they're going to try to do with BO6, along with maybe watched my or other people's videos on what's coming. Or maybe you've seen the leaks on social media or in videos as well. We'll talk about all that. Frankly, I think the game is in a good state with what they've shown so far. I can't talk about my direct experience playing the game. I'm still under NDA. We cannot speak on that. With that being said, this is not a video saying, good job, Treyarch, pat on the back. There are some great things, but this is also a video over what also needs to happen for me personally, and I think for overall as a player base, right? So just a few important points, right? Classic prestiging. I think we all agree that's pretty damn good. We're happy with that. Although it's not totally classic prestige, which is fine. It's fine. It's regular prestige up until max prestige, level 55, and then you hit master prestige, which is up to level 1,000. That was basically what happened in like Advanced Warfare, I think. I actually think that prestige system is great. And there's no level cap. Even better. You can get your levels when you want to. There's going to be like 9 or 12 new guns they had talked about. Totally new guns to the franchise. That doesn't mean that's all there is. There will be other guns brought back that you maybe have seen before, like an M4 or an ACR or something like that. They always have a 30-round magazine low recoil rifle. That's like in every game. It's just that's the way it is. So there will be guns like that brought back, and attachments, I'm sure, and then some totally new guns and some totally new attachments. I think they've talked about the new guns, but I don't have them on hand at the moment. There's 16 new maps, totally new maps, also really good. That also doesn't mean they're not going to bring some maps back. I think some people said in the trailer, as a leak, they saw Nuketown. They showed it, and that was very widely accepted. I actually didn't watch the footage myself, so I can't corroborate that, but it's a Treyarch game. It's likely going to have Nuketown, right? Additionally, theater mode, big W, positive, no negative to that at all. Now, for those of you that are saying, hey, I want this, I want that, I want some other things, I get that. Wanting more is always what we do. We always want more. But to have back a lot of the things that we used to have, and hopefully, because of the positive feedback they see from us as players, we like the classic prestige, we love the theater mode, we love this stuff that they're bringing back, they will continue to have that in future games. That was one of the questions I asked them while I was out there, and I can actually talk about this. I said, if theater mode is so well liked by a lot of us, why isn't it in every game? And they basically said, we would love to do it in every game, but it kind of has to be reciprocated from the fans that, hey, that is a feature and desire that we really want, and it has to be communicated a lot, I guess. Personally, I don't know what more we can do besides say, hey, we want this a lot, but that's the vibe that that's what they answered with. That was the vibe they gave off, that it's kind of on us to dictate what they can work on. And in the end, they are a development studio. They are owned by Activision, I believe, which is now owned by Microsoft. So I don't know if they have the final say in a lot of the stuff that they spend their time on. They probably have the overall arc, but they have to get the approval from people above them and so on and so forth. So it's up to us, I think, as fans to say, hey, we want this feature in the future games. Going forward, there are a lot of things in the game that I would love to see either not in the game or would love to see done better from what we've had the last 2 years, right? And so I can't talk on this stuff from my direct gameplay experience, but I can tell you as a player and as a fan, this is stuff that I would want to see in the game. Whether it's there or not, I will not tell you. Some things I don't know, some things I do, but this is what I would want in the game, all right? We do not know, and this is the huge one, what matchmaking will be like. Okay, we have no clue. No idea. I would assume it's going to be very similar as to what it already is, which is disappointing to people. I get that. As someone who plays the game every day and tries to bring you fun videos using off-meta stuff, I get that more than basically any of you. Unless you guys also have 20 days played in every Call of Duty using off-meta items. And I can prove it. If you go look at any of my weapons, like I don't have even the MCW, the FJX Horus, any of these guns, the Rival 9, I don't even have like the new Mastery Gold Camo unlocked, let alone like the Onyx one. I barely use weapons. I switch around nonstop for videos because I think that's what people would enjoy seeing. I don't think you guys want to watch the same thing all the time. And once in a while, I do put on the tryhard guns and do a tryhard video with friends. And that's fun too. But I like to use a large variety of things. And that definitely is a major punishing factor when it comes to the matchmaking system. I do not like heavy skill-based matchmaking. I do not like heavy engagement-optimized matchmaking system. Engagement-optimized matchmaking? And I know people will argue, hey, one of these EOMM isn't in the game. In my mind, it is in a way. Okay? The game is trying to be optimized to have the most fun and include the most playtime from the average player. Now, when you are a good enough player that you fall outside the average by a large margin or a decent margin, you do not fit the matchmaking scheme. You don't. The problem is, a lot of people do fit the matchmaking scheme. And this might sound mean, most of you that watch this video are not good enough to complain about skill-based matchmaking, in my opinion. You fit inside the matchmaking bubble, you know? If you're a 1 KD, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3 even, in anywhere from like a 0.7 to a 1.3, you are the system. The system is designed for you, really. When you enter the 2s, the 3s, the 4s in the KD department, where the game basically dictates that you are the whole team in a majority of your games, it might feel like you're getting screwed. I get that. That's the matchmaking system makes it kind of difficult for you even as a lower skilled player, but the system is there for you. I promise. The lobbies that you see me play in whenever I play with my low-level account, I have a PlayStation. I'll join my low-level account. It's like a 0.8, 0.9 KD account. And I ask the people KDs in those lobbies. They are the 1 KD players. And it looks like a festival of clown. I mean, it is. I am destroying them. It's not even close. Those are the average people in the game. The lobbies that I'm in, most people are Crimson Iridescent players. And they like to sweat, frankly. So I am not a fan of the matchmaking system, but I don't see it changing. It benefits a majority of the people. I say this all the time. I can hate it as much as I want. And you're like, well, why do you play it if you still hate it? My options here are limited. This is a job now for me. I can play other games, and I do on my second channel, which if you guys watch that, I'm glad you watch it. I need to post more. I'm sorry. It's been busy this last month especially. But I do like the arcade style of shooting games like Call of Duty, and there just aren't a lot of options out there. Yes, I have tried X-Defiant. Yes, I'm waiting on X-Defiant One Life mode. I don't play Respawn in Call of Duty either. Don't like it. It's not fun to me. I don't enjoy it. So, will I try other games? Yeah, I do. If I post them, though, and people don't watch them, then I'm not going to continue playing them either. Frankly, that's just how it works. I want to play what you guys want to watch most of the time. That being said, I don't agree with it. I don't like it. Okay? But I have to just deal. It's either you play the old game that has it, or you play the new game that has it. Because frankly, at this point, all their games have it. They have for the last decade. As crazy as it seems, Advanced Warfare was the time they turned up skill-based matchmaking. That was 10 years ago. So it's in every game now. And they might change it at some point, but I wouldn't hold your breath. I wouldn't, unfortunately. All right. Let's move past matchmaking, because that was a heavily contested, argued point. I don't know what the UI will be like. I hope it is better. They've done some improvements on Modern Warfare 3. Unfortunately, I think they were still kind of stuck with having to use the base of Modern Warfare 2 to build the Modern Warfare 3 menu. I don't know if that's completely true, but they were limited because of that, I thought. And so they've done some things to improve it, especially even recently by putting your friends list on the main page versus having to hit O for going to social or going to the top bar and find them. That was a great improvement. I would love, and they've shown some stuff on the menu, I think, already, trying to simplify it and bring it back to what we had, you know, before, where you have your simple, maybe not even vertical, you can keep horizontal, but vertical, you know, find a game, you know, in custom game, invite a friend, whatever it might be, have your friends list there really quick and easy, being able to kick people from the party or give someone else leader just on the main menu, not have to go into the social tab and try to find the party. A lot of stuff needs to be simplified in the UI. I hope it is, because the UI was a disaster in Modern Warfare 2. I mean, I never knew how annoying that thing could actually be. Like, I would have never complained about the UI 10 years ago or 15 years ago, but when you make it so hard to navigate, it all of a sudden becomes an issue that you never even considered. So I hope the UI is much better and more intuitive. We do not know about the new mechanics and how they're going to be incorporated into Warzone, okay? That could be, I mean, not important for me, because I don't really care about Warzone that much. But it is an important thing for a lot of people out there that play Warzone. And because Warzone's free to play, it is definitely one of the most widely played versions of Call of Duty. So will Warzone have this new omnidirectional movement, being able to dolphin dive, slide, and jump in every direction? Will they limit the movement again because maybe they're incorporating the new movement in, so they're either going to take away all the things that they gave you automatically, like automatic or like faster, I don't know, longer sprint, faster climbing. They have all these like 5 or 4 features now they included automatically from MW2. They're not in multiplayer. Actually, the mantle now is in multiplayer. But how will Warzone change? Because that's a big, I mean, don't get me wrong. Again, that doesn't affect me hugely, but I don't want the game to be bad at any point. I want people to enjoy every aspect of it, whether it is zombies and round-based zombies now for you guys that love zombies, or if it's for the multiplayer boys that play like I do, or for the Warzone guys that want to play Warzone a lot. How are the new mechanics, how is the new movement, how are the new guns, how is all that stuff going to be incorporated into Warzone? And will it be better? Will there be a new map for those guys? Will they be going back to Old Verdansk, which a lot of people have wanted? That's a big one, too. So, how will Warzone change? We don't know. We have to wait and see. These are all things that we have to kind of wait and see on, and hopefully the game is better. And hopefully they're all kind of there with what we want as players, so the game is better. For me, this is a personal preference. Don't know about Dead Silence as a perk. And if Dead Silence is a perk, we don't know if Awareness is a perk. Because if you have Dead Silence and all of a sudden there's Awareness, then Awareness counters it, then there's no point in having Dead Silence to begin with because everyone just uses both of them. I think Dead Silence has to be a perk. And I know some people disagree with that because, oh, they can sneak up on you. It's called game awareness. Get fucking better. I mean, frankly, it's your fault. You just suck. You should figure out where people are coming from, be able to know where to look. I am totally fine with Dead Silence as a perk. I am totally fine if they get rid of the whole sound EQ thing or loudness EQ thing on PC. I would love that. The only reason I have it on is because other people have it on, and I hate dying to shit when I can't, you know, if they're going to use it and I'm not, I hate it. I hate it. But if we both don't have it, totally cool with it. Totally fine. Dead Silence, I think, is the most important perk for Search and Destroy, though, because it does highlight map awareness and game awareness as a player. So, and I think, you know, people are like, oh, the old CODs were way better. Old CODs had Dead Silence. Black Ops 2 had it. MW2 had it. Modern Warfare 3 had it. Black Ops 3 had it. All of them had it, actually. They had it. Now, some of those did have awareness. Not a fan. Although the awareness wasn't as good. Additionally, I would say that those games were different back then because a lot of people, and this might be weird to say, but a lot of people did not have good headsets and super optimized audio. We fucking do now. We do. Everyone does, you know? Pretty much. And so you have to just limit what people can hear because they can hear everything now. So, yeah, Dead Silence perk, would love to see it. No awareness. Now, we don't know how the game as a live service is going to be treated. That's a big one. And when I say that, like live service, what does that mean? Continual updates throughout the year. How fast will they respond to feedback? How fast will they buff, nerf things? How fast will they fix bugs and glitches, especially major ones? Will they have consistent events like they have throughout this year, which has been pretty cool in my opinion. I like it a lot. How many new maps will be added in on every new season if they're doing new seasons? I don't know if they're going to do seasons. I assume they will. How many new perks? How many new perk bonuses? How many new equipment are they going to include? How many kill streaks? And perk bonus, if you don't know what that is, it's a new thing in the game where there are 3 different types of perks. Essentially, there's an aggressive one, a scouting one, and a camping one. Okay? And if you use 3 of the same type of perk, you get a perk bonus. Well, you could have extra bonuses. You could say if you use 2 of this one and 1 of the other, they'll get you this bonus. If you use 1 of each kind, it will get you this bonus. And for example, if you use 3 of the aggressive ones, it will give you, I think they said, faster movement when you get a kill and faster health regen. So you get like a movement boost when you get a kill and your health regen's a little bit quicker, like quick fix maybe. So they're pretty useful and they could have more perk bonuses added in. It'd be cool to see more, actually. I think they could, I mean, some of them, I can't talk about that, actually. I can only mention the one. I'm not gonna break NDA for you guys. You're not gonna get me, all right? I've seen some other, that's all I can say. But we don't know how this movement system, oh, okay, yeah. This is a big one, too. How will the movement system be optimized and abused? The new omnidirectional movement system is cool. I think it's really cool, and it's be fun for kill cams. Being able to shoot while dolphin diving and stuff will be hilarious for some kill cams. But how optimized can it become, and how abused can it become? And I give an example that, you know, one of Treyarch's games was Black Ops 3, and you guys maybe played it, maybe you liked it. I did. But there was a movement glitch in that game that was in the game for probably a few months until they fixed it finally, called the G-Slide. and it basically gave you much faster mobility and movement on the rush route. Now, it was a difficult button combination to hit correctly and time it properly, but once you kind of got used to it, good players all did the G-slide, and we were able to rush very fast because of it. I imagine there's going to be more kind of movement quirks, is probably the best way to put it, that will give you advantages, whether it might be, you know, like how you can snake in Call of Duty, or how you can do the G-slide in BO3. There's probably going to be something similar along those lines that make it very difficult to be targeted and give you an advantage when you're targeting other people. So I assume the movement system is not finalized. It will still be tinkered with, even on the live game. And we're going to have to wait and see how that is. Right now, you're kind of seeing that with X Defiant, where they're like, hey, look, people that are spamming the bunny hop button or jump button or bunny hopping, you're doing it too much, and it's making the game too difficult for people to aim. And so they reduced the amount that you can bunny hop, essentially. They said, hey, you can only spam your jump button like 2 times, 3 times before it makes your gun really inaccurate and the sway hits it and stuff like that. So I expect there to be some weird stuff with the movement system. Any type of totally new system incorporated into the game, even the normal one, is usually found, they usually find some type of buggy, difficult to track button combo, and you have the advantage when you do it. So it'll be weird. This is a really new movement system, and that being said, I'm really curious if this movement system will be popular, and if it is, will it be in every Call of Duty in the future? If people like what they play and they like it, I wonder if it'll be like every next Call of Duty is now this movement system, which it's possible. I think that covers most of what I wanted to talk about, though, in terms of like, hey, I'm happy where the game is right now. I'm really happy to see all the stuff that they're adding back or that they're going to be including in the game. And I'm still wary, though. I'm still wary and concerned with some other aspects of the game. Like I said, the UI, the movement we just talked about, the matchmaking, Dead Silence as a perk, how will the game act as a live service over for a full year this game is going to be played. Will it do consistent updates very quickly, or will they have them spread out? Will it be more like how we have it right now? Will the events continue, etc.? So if you have questions, feel free to ask in the comments. Sometimes devs watch videos, and sometimes they like to read through stuff and try to address them in announcements at some point, so can't hurt. Thanks for watching. If you do enjoy, leave a like, subscribe. I do appreciate you having me back and watching. And yeah, thanks again.